Arsenic poisoning, Wikipedia article audio. Arsenic poisoning is a medical condition that occurs due to elevated levels of arsenic in the body. If exposure occurs over a brief period of time, symptoms may include vomiting, abdominal pain, encephalopathy, and watery diarrhea that contains blood. Long-term exposure can result in thickening of the skin, darker skin, abdominal pain, diarrhea, heart disease, numbness, and cancer. The most common reason for long-term exposure is contaminated drinking water. Groundwater most often becomes contaminated naturally, however, contamination may also occur from mining or agriculture. Recommended levels in water are less than 1050 g/L. Other routes of exposure include toxic waste sites and traditional medicines. Most cases of poisoning are accidental. Arsenic acts by changing the functioning of around 200 enzymes. Diagnosis is by testing the urine, blood, or hair. Signs and symptoms. Cancer. Prevention is by using water that does not contain high levels of arsenic. This may be achieved by the use of special filters or using rainwater. There is not good evidence to support specific treatments for long-term poisoning. For acute poisonings, treating dehydration is important. Dimercaptosuccinic acid or dimercaptopropane sulfonate may be used while dimercaprol is not recommended. Hemodialysis may also be used. Through drinking water, more than 200 million people globally are exposed to higher than safe levels of arsenic. The areas most affected are Bangladesh and West Bengal. Acute poisoning is uncommon. The toxicity of arsenic has been described as far back as 1500 BC in the Ebers Papyrus. Symptoms of arsenic poisoning begin with headaches, confusion, severe diarrhea, and drowsiness. As the poisoning develops, convulsions and changes in fingernail pigmentation called lucernicia striata may occur. When the poisoning becomes acute, symptoms may include diarrhea, vomiting, vomiting blood, blood in the urine, cramping muscles, hair loss, stomach pain, and more convulsions. The organs of the body that are usually affected by arsenic poisoning are the lungs, skin, kidneys, and liver. The final result of arsenic poisoning is coma and death. Arsenic is related to heart disease, cancer, stroke, chronic lower respiratory diseases, and diabetes. Chronic exposure to arsenic is related to vitamin A deficiency, which is related to heart disease and night blindness. Causes. Inorganic arsenites in drinking water have a much higher acute toxicity than organic arsenates. The acute minimal lethal dose of arsenic in adults is estimated to be 70 to 200 mg or 1 mg/kg/day. Arsenic increases the risk of cancer. Exposure is related to skin, lung, liver, and kidney cancer, among others. Drinking water. Its comedogenic effects may be explained by interference with base and nucleotide excision repair, eventually through interaction with zinc finger structures. Dimethylarsenic acid, DMA, caused DNA single-strand breaks resulting from inhibition of repair enzymes at levels of 5 to 100 mm in human epithelial type 2 cells. MMA and DMA were also shown to be directly genotoxic by effectuating scissions in supercoiled Phi-X174 DNA. Increased arsenic exposure is associated with an increased frequency of chromosomal aberrations, micronuclei, and sister chromatid exchanges. An explanation for chromosomal aberrations is the sensitivity of the protein tubulin and the mitotic spindle to arsenic. Histological observations confirm effects on cellular integrity, shape, and locomotion. DMA is able to form reactive oxygen species by reaction with molecular oxygen. Resulting metabolites are the dimethyl arsenic radical and the dimethyl arsenic peroxyl radical. Both DMA and DMA were shown to release iron from horse spleen as well as from human liver ferritin if ascorbic acid was administered simultaneously. Thus, formation of ROS can be promoted. Moreover, arsenic could cause oxidative stress by depleting the cell's antioxidants, especially the ones containing thiol groups. The accumulation of ROS like the cited above in hydroxyl radicals, superoxide radicals, and hydrogen peroxides causes aberrant gene expression at low concentrations and lesions of lipids, proteins and DNA in higher concentrations which eventually lead to cellular death. In a rat animal model, urine levels of 8-hydroxy-2-desoxyguanosine were measured after treatment with DMA. In comparison to control levels, they turned out to be significantly increased. This theory is further supported by a cross-sectional study which found elevated mean serum lipid peroxides in the as-exposed individuals which correlated with blood levels of inorganic arsenic and methylated metabolites and inversely correlated with non-protein sulfhydryl levels in whole blood. Another study found an association of AS levels in whole blood with the level of reactive oxidants in plasma and an inverse relationship with plasma antioxidants. A finding of the latter study indicates that methylation might in fact be a detoxification pathway with regard to oxidative stress. The results showed that the lower the AS methylation capacity was, the lower the level of plasma antioxidant capacity. As reviewed by Kitchen, the oxidative stress theory provides an explanation for the preferred tumor sites connected with arsenic exposure. Considering that a high partial pressure of oxygen is present in lungs and DMA is excreted in gaseous state via the lungs, this seems to be a plausible mechanism for special vulnerability. The fact that DMA is produced by methylation in the liver, excreted via the kidneys and later on stored in the bladder accounts for the other tumor localizations. Occupational exposures. Regarding DNA methylation, some studies suggest interaction of AS with methyltransferases which leads to an inactivation of tumor suppressor genes through hypermethylation. Others state that hypomethylation might occur due to a lack of SAM resulting in aberrant gene activation. An experiment by Zhong et al. With arsenite-exposed human lung A549, kidney UOK123, UOK109 and UOK121 cells isolated 8 different DNA fragments by methylation-sensitive arbitrarily primed PCR. It turned out that 6 of the fragments were hyper and 2 of them were hypomethylated. Higher levels of DNA methyltransferase mRNA and enzyme activity were found. Food. Kitchen proposed a model of altered growth factors which lead to cell proliferation and thus to carcinogenesis. From observations, it is known that chronic low-dose arsenic poisoning can lead to increased tolerance to its acute toxicity. MRP1 overexpressing lung tumor GLC4/SB30 cells poorly accumulate arsenite and arsenate. This is mediated through MRP1-dependent efflux. The efflux requires GSH, but no AS-GSH complex formation. Pathophysiology. Although many mechanisms have been proposed, no definite model can be given for the mechanisms of chronic arsenic poisoning. The prevailing events of toxicity and carcinogenicity might be quite tissue-specific. Current consensus on the mode of carcinogenesis is that it acts primarily as a tumor promoter. Its CO carcinogenicity has been demonstrated in several models. However, the finding of several studies that chronically arsenic-exposed Andean populations do not develop skin cancer with chronic arsenic exposure is puzzling. Organic arsenic is less harmful than inorganic arsenic. Seafood is a common source of the less toxic organic arsenic in the form of arsenobutane. The arsenic reported in 2012 in fruit juice and rice by Consumer Reports was primarily inorganic arsenic. Mechanism. Chronic arsenic poisoning results from drinking contaminated well water over a long period of time. Many aquifers contain high concentration of arsenic salts. The World Health Organization recommends a limit of 0.01 mg/L of arsenic in drinking water. This recommendation was established based on the limit of detection for most laboratories' testing equipment at the time of publication of the WHO Water Quality Guidelines. More recent findings show that consumption of water with levels as low as 0.00017 mg/L over long periods of time can lead to arsenicosis. From a 1988 study in China, the U.S. Protection Agency quantified the lifetime exposure of arsenic in drinking water at concentrations of 0.0017 mg/L, 0.00017 mg/L, and 0.00017 mg/L are associated with a lifetime skin cancer risk of 1 in 10,000, 1 in 100,000, and 1 in 1 million respectively. WHO asserts that a water level of 0.01 mg/L poses a risk of 6 in 10,000 chance of lifetime skin cancer risk and contends that this level of risk is acceptable. One of the worst incidents of arsenic poisoning via well water occurred in Bangladesh, which the World Health Organization called the largest mass poisoning of a population in history. Mining techniques such as hydraulic fracturing may mobilize arsenic in groundwater and aquifers due to enhanced methane transport and resulting changes in redox conditions, and inject fluid containing additional arsenic. Because of its high toxicity, arsenic is seldom used in the Western world, although in Asia it is still a popular pesticide. Arsenic is mainly encountered occupationally in the smelting of zinc and copper ores. Kinetics. It has been found that rice is particularly susceptible to accumulation of arsenic from soil. Rice grown in the U.S. has an average 260 ppb of arsenic, according to a study, but U.S. arsenic intake remains far below World Health Organization recommended limits. China has set a standard for arsenic limits in food, as levels in rice exceed those in water. Heat shock response. Arsenic is a ubiquitous element present in American drinking water. In the United States, levels of arsenic that are above natural levels, but still well below danger levels set in federal safety standards, have been detected in commercially raised chickens. The source of the arsenic appears to be the feed additives roxarsone and nitarsone, which are used to control the parasitic infection coccidiosis as well as to increase weight and skin coloring of the poultry. High levels of inorganic arsenic were reportedly found in 83 California wines in 2015. Arsenic interferes with cellular longevity by allosteric inhibition of an essential metabolic enzyme pyruvate dehydrogenase complex, which catalyzes the oxidation of pyruvate to acetyl-CoA by NAD+. With the enzyme inhibited, the energy system of the cell is disrupted, resulting in cellular apoptosis. Biochemically, arsenic prevents use of thiamine, resulting in a clinical picture resembling thiamine deficiency. Poisoning with arsenic can raise lactate levels and lead to lactic acidosis. Low potassium levels in the cells increases the risk of experiencing a life-threatening heart rhythm problem from arsenic trioxide. Arsenic in cells clearly stimulates the production of hydrogen peroxide. When the H2O2 reacts with certain metals such as iron or manganese, it produces a highly reactive hydroxyl radical. Inorganic arsenic trioxide found in groundwater particularly affects voltage-gated potassium channels, disrupting cellular electrolytic function, resulting in neurological disturbances, cardiovascular episodes such as prolonged QT interval, neutropenia, high blood pressure, central nervous system dysfunction, anemia, and death. Arsenic exposure plays a key role in the pathogenesis of vascular endothelial dysfunction, as it inactivates endothelial nitric oxide synthase, leading to reduction in the generation and bioavailability of nitric oxide. In addition, the chronic arsenic exposure induces high oxidative stress, which may affect the structure and function of cardiovascular system. Further, the arsenic exposure has been noted to induce atherosclerosis by increasing the platelet aggregation and reducing fibrinolysis. Moreover, arsenic exposure may cause arrhythmia by increasing the QT interval and accelerating the cellular calcium overload. The chronic exposure to arsenic upregulates the expression of tumor necrosis factor alpha, interleukin-1, vascular cell adhesion molecule, and vascular endothelial growth factor to induce cardiovascular pathogenesis. Oxidative stress. Diagnosis. Treatment. Chelation. Tissue culture studies have shown that arsenic compounds block both IKR and X channels and, at the same time, activates IKK ADP channels. Arsenic compounds also disrupt ADP production through several mechanisms. At the level of the citric acid cycle, arsenic inhibits pyruvate dehydrogenase, and by competing with phosphate it uncouples oxidative phosphorylation, thus inhibiting energy-linked reduction of NAD+, mitochondrial respiration, and ADP synthesis. Hydrogen peroxide production is also increased, which might form reactive oxygen species and oxidative stress. These metabolic interferences lead to death from multi-system organ failure, probably from necrotic cell death, not apoptosis. A post-mortem reveals brick red-colored mucosa, due to severe hemorrhage. Although arsenic causes toxicity, it can also play a protective role. Arsenite inhibits not only the formation of acetyl-CoA but also the enzyme succinic dehydrogenase. Arsenate can replace phosphate in many reactions. It is able to form GLC6 arsenate in vitro, therefore it has been argued that hexokinase could be inhibited. In the glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate dehydrogenase reaction, arsenate attacks the enzyme-bound thioester. The formed 1-arseno-3-phosphoglycerate is unstable and hydrolyzes spontaneously. Thus, ADP formation in glycolysis is inhibited while bypassing the phosphoglycerate kinase reaction. As shown by Gresser, submitochondrial particles synthesize adenosine 5-diphosphate arsenate from ADP and arsenate in presence of succinate. Thus, by a variety of mechanisms, arsenate leads to an impairment of cell respiration and subsequently diminished ADP formation. This is consistent with observed ADP depletion of exposed cells and histopathological findings of mitochondrial and cell swelling, glycogen depletion in liver cells, and fatty change in liver, heart, and kidney. Experiments demonstrated enhanced arterial thrombosis in a rat animal model, elevations of serotonin levels, thromboxane A and adhesion proteins in platelets, while human platelets showed similar responses. The effect on vascular endothelium may eventually be mediated by the arsenic-induced formation of nitric oxide. It was demonstrated that +3S concentrations substantially lower than concentrations required for inhibition of the lysosomal protease cathepsin L in B cell line TA3 were sufficient to trigger apoptosis in the same B cell line, while the latter could be a mechanism mediating immunosuppressive effects. The two forms of inorganic arsenic, reduced and oxidized, can be absorbed and accumulated in tissues and body fluids. In the liver, the metabolism of arsenic involves enzymatic and non-enzymatic methylation. The most frequently excreted metabolite in the urine of mammals is dimethylarsenic acid or cacodylic acid, DMA. Dimethylarsenic acid is also known as Agent Blue and was used as herbicide in the American War in Vietnam. In humans, inorganic arsenic is reduced non-enzymatically from pentoxide to trioxide using glutathione, or it is mediated by enzymes. Reduction of arsenic pentoxide to arsenic trioxide increases its toxicity and bioavailability. Methylation occurs through methyltransferase enzymes. S-adenosylmethionine may serve as methyl donor. Various pathways are used, the principal route being dependent on the current environment of the cell. Resulting metabolites are monomethylarsenic acid, MMA, and dimethylarsenic acid, DMA. Methylation had been regarded as a detoxification process, but reduction from +5S to +3S may be considered as a bioactivation instead. Another suggestion is that methylation might be a detoxification if, as intermediates are not permitted to accumulate because the pentavalent organoarsenics have a lower affinity to thiol groups than inorganic pentavalent arsenics. Gebel stated that methylation is a detoxification through accelerated excretion. With regard to carcinogenicity, it has been suggested that methylation should be regarded as a toxification. Arsenic, especially +3S, binds to single, but with higher affinity to vicinal sulfhydryl groups, thus reacts with a variety of proteins and inhibits their activity. It was also proposed that binding of arsenite at non-essential sites might contribute to detoxification. Arsenite inhibits members of the disulfide oxidoreductase family like glutathione reductase and thioredoxin reductase. Nutrition. The remaining unbound arsenic accumulates in cells, which over time may lead to skin, bladder, kidney, liver, lung, and prostate cancers. Other forms of arsenic toxicity in humans have been observed in blood, bone marrow, cardiac, central nervous system, gastrointestinal, gonadal, kidney, liver, pancreatic, and skin tissues. Another aspect is the similarity of arsenic effects to the heat shock response. Short-term arsenic exposure has effects on signal transduction inducing heat shock proteins with masses of 27,60,70,72,90,110 kDa, as well as metalloocinean, ubiquitin, mitogen-activated kinases, extracellular regulated kinase, c-Jun terminal kinases and P38. Via JNK and P38 it activates CFOS, c-Jun, and EGR1, which are usually activated by growth factors and cytokines. The effects are largely dependent on the dosing regime and may be as well inversed. As shown by some experiments reviewed by Del Razzo, ROS induced by low levels of inorganic arsenic increase the transcription and the activity of the activator protein 1 and the nuclear factor kappa B, which results in CFOS/C-Jun activation, oversecretion of pro-inflammatory and growth-promoting cytokines stimulating cell proliferation. Germolic ETAL found an increased cytokine expression and cell proliferation in skin biopsies from individuals chronically exposed to arsenic-contaminated drinking water. History. Increased AP1 and NF-kappa B obviously also result in an upregulation of MDM2 protein, which decreases P53 protein levels. Thus, taking into account P53's function, a lack of it could cause a faster accumulation of mutations contributing to carcinogenesis. However, high levels of inorganic arsenic inhibit NF-kappa B activation and cell proliferation. An experiment of HuETAL demonstrated increased binding activity of AP1 and NF-kappa B after acute exposure to +3 sodium arsenite, whereas long-term exposure yielded the opposite result. The authors conclude that the former may be interpreted as a defense response while the latter could lead to carcinogenesis. As the contradicting findings and connected mechanistic hypotheses indicate, there is a difference in acute and chronic effects of arsenic on signal transduction which is not clearly understood yet. Studies have demonstrated that the oxidative stress generated by arsenic may disrupt the signal transduction pathways of the nuclear transcriptional factors PPARs, AP1, and NF-kappa B, as well as the pro-inflammatory cytokines IL-8 and TNF-alpha. The interference of oxidative stress with signal transduction pathways may affect physiological processes associated with cell growth, metabolic syndrome X, glucose homeostasis, lipid metabolism, obesity, insulin resistance, inflammation, and diabetes 2. Recent scientific evidence has elucidated the physiological roles of the PPARs in the omega-hydroxylation of fatty acids and the inhibition of pro-inflammatory transcription factors, pro-inflammatory cytokines, CELL4 adhesion molecules, inducible nitric oxide synthase, pro-inflammatory nitric oxide, and anti-apoptotic factors. Epidemiological studies have suggested a correlation between chronic consumption of drinking water contaminated with arsenic and the incidence of type 2 diabetes. The human liver after exposure to therapeutic drugs may exhibit hepatic non-cirrhotic portal hypertension, fibrosis, and cirrhosis. However, the literature provides insufficient scientific evidence to show cause and effect between arsenic and the onset of diabetes mellitus type 2. Arsenic may be measured in blood or urine to monitor excessive environmental or occupational exposure, confirm a diagnosis of poisoning in hospitalized victims, or to assist in the forensic investigation in a case of fatal overdosage. Some analytical techniques are capable of distinguishing organic from inorganic forms of the element. Organic arsenic compounds tend to be eliminated in the urine in unchanged form, while inorganic forms are largely converted to organic arsenic compounds in the body prior to urinary excretion. The current biological exposure index for U.S. workers of 35 g/L total urinary arsenic may easily be exceeded by a healthy person eating a seafood meal. Tests are available to diagnose poisoning by measuring arsenic in blood, urine, hair, and fingernails. The urine test is the most reliable test for arsenic exposure within the last few days. Urine testing needs to be done within 24-48 hours for an accurate analysis of an acute exposure. Tests on hair and fingernails can measure exposure to high levels of arsenic over the past 6-12 months. These tests can determine if one has been exposed to above-average levels of arsenic. They cannot predict, however, whether the arsenic levels in the body will affect health. Chronic arsenic exposure can remain in the body's systems for a longer period of time than a shorter term or more isolated exposure and can be detected in a longer time frame after the introduction of the arsenic, important in trying to determine the source of the exposure. Hair is a potential bioindicator for arsenic exposure due to its ability to store trace elements from blood. Incorporated elements maintain their position during growth of hair. Thus, for a temporal estimation of exposure, an assay of hair composition needs to be carried out with a single hair, which is not possible with older techniques requiring homogenization and dissolution of several strands of hair. This type of biomonitoring has been achieved with newer microanalytical techniques like synchrotron radiation-based X-ray fluorescence spectroscopy and microparticle-induced X-ray emission. The highly focused and intense beams study small spots on biological samples, allowing analysis to micro level along with the chemical speciation. In a study, this method has been used to follow arsenic level before, during and after treatment with arsenious oxide in patients with acute promyelocytic leukemia. Dimercaprol and dimercaptosuccinic acid are chelating agents that sequester the arsenic away from blood proteins and are used in treating acute arsenic poisoning. The most important side effect is hypertension. Dimercaprol is considerably more toxic than succimer. DMSA monoesters, e.g. MEA-DMSA, are promising antidotes for arsenic poisoning. Calcium sodium etatate is also used. Supplemental potassium decreases the risk of experiencing a life-threatening heart rhythm problem from arsenic trioxide. In addition to its presence as a poison, for centuries arsenic was used medicinally. It has been used for over 2,400 years as a part of traditional Chinese medicine. In the Western world, arsenic compounds, such as salvarsan, were used extensively to treat syphilis before penicillin was introduced. It was eventually replaced as a therapeutic agent by sulfa drugs and then by other antibiotics. Arsenic was also an ingredient in many tonics. In addition, during the Elizabethan era, some women used a mixture of vinegar, chalk, and arsenic applied topically to whiten their skin. This use of arsenic was intended to prevent aging and creasing of the skin, but some arsenic was inevitably absorbed into the bloodstream. During the Victorian era in the United States, U.S. newspapers advertised arsenic complexion wafers. These wafers promised to help get rid of blemishes on the face such as moles and pimples. Some pigments, most notably the popular emerald green, were based on arsenic compounds. Overexposure to these pigments was a frequent cause of accidental poisoning of artists and craftsmen. Arsenic became a favored method for murder of the Middle Ages and Renaissance, particularly among ruling classes in Italy allegedly. Because the symptoms are similar to those of cholera, which was common at the time, arsenic poisoning often went undetected. 63 By the 19th century, it had acquired the nickname inheritance powder, perhaps because impatient heirs were known or suspected to use it to ensure or accelerate their inheritances. 21 It was also a common murder technique in the 19th century in domestic violence situations, such as the case of Rebecca Copin, who attempted to poison her husband by putting arsenic in his coffee. In ancient Korea, and particularly in Joseon Dynasty, arsenic sulfur compounds have been used as a major ingredient of sayak, which was a poison cocktail used in capital punishment of high-profile political figures and members of the royal family. Due to social and political prominence of the condemned, many of these events were well documented, often in the annals of Joseon Dynasty, they are sometimes portrayed in historical television miniseries because of their dramatic nature.